right. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. Hey, this is the day that the Lord have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning to you, and thank you so much for tuning in to our Kingdom Life Sunday morning worship experience today. Listen, we don't own the rights to this music, but listen, we need y'all to come on in and worship with us today. Share, like, tag, invite, start a watch party this morning. Man, let's have a great time in the Lord. Listen, I don't know about you, but I'm ready for overflow this morning.
Oh, yeah.
So let's worship Him today. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, God. Thank you.
I'm getting ready to sing. Y'all come on in, share, like, tag, invite. Start a watch party today. Let's get other people to be a part of our Kingdom Life worship experience this morning.
Good morning, Sheila Rogie. Good morning, Robert Perryman. Booby, good morning. Good morning, Johnny Johnson. Good morning, Miss Teresa Wells. How are you today? Thanks for joining us. Again, please share, tag, like, invite, start a watch party. Invite a few of your family members and friends to join us. I'm telling you, our Sunday morning worship service is going to be amazing. We have a word. We have a word for you on today.
Yeah, we do. Listen, I already spotted a mistake already in this service, but
Okay. Listen,
we're going to get it together. Let's just worship here in just a moment.
That's right.
And then we're going to get it taken care of here in just a minute.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Y'all come on in, share, like, tag, invite. Start a watch party. Get other people to come on. Turn that one off. Y'all come on in, share, like, tag, invite. Start a watch party with us this morning. We're going to have a great time in the Lord today. I promise you we are. Good morning, Miss Geraldine Moore. Thank you so much for being on today. Sister Shirley Sanders is on today. Shout out to you. Thank you so much for tuning in this morning. Good to see you guys.
Again, if you haven't gotten your communion articles this morning, go ahead and get your communion articles, your bread, your grape juice, your crackers. We're going to do communion on today.
Yes. Y'all come on in, share, like, tag, invite this morning. Let's worship God.
All right, we have a few more people joining us on today. Good morning, Tiffany Barnes. Thanks for joining us on today.
Yes.
Again, please go ahead and share, tag, like, invite, start a watch party. Make sure you invite a few of your family members and friends to join us on this morning.
Please do. Mother Sandra Jones is in the house.
Hello, Mother Sandra Jones. We've been praying for you as well. Thank you, Father. Yes, God. Yes.
Y'all come on in. Come on, share, like, tag, invite. Start a watch party this morning. Get other people to come on and be a part of our Kingdom Life worship experience today. Today is going to be exceptional. It's going to be phenomenal. It's going to be fantastic. Man, it's going to be life-changing today. We're going to be starting a new teaching series this morning. So you want to be a part.
Thank you, Father. Yes.
Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for overflow today.
Oh, yes,
I'm ready for overflow. Listen, we're getting ready to get our communion here in just a moment. But we need you to get your communion elements today. We didn't have communion last week. Totally slipped our mind. Got caught up in the impact giving. But hey, what we need from y'all is come on in this morning. Share, like, tag, invite, start a watch party with us today. We're getting ready to have communion today. I know this is not traditional where normally people do communion on the first Sunday of the month.
Right.
But I do know some churches who do communion on the second Sunday of the month.
Yes, we do.
And so, but listen, we're going to get into it this morning. We're going to have a great time in the Lord. And what we need for you to do, we need you to share. We need you to like. We need you to tag. We need you to invite. We need you to start a watch party. We need you to do that because we're going to have a great time in the Lord, all right? The mistake that we had, we was broadcasting from two different cameras on the same Overseer Pyramid page. So divide up everybody. So that's why Treasure had to turn it off. It was supposed to be broadcast from the Kingdom Life Faith Center page, and somehow or another we didn't get it that way.
Right.
So, but y'all come on in this morning, all right? Hey, shout out to the Haywoods who are on this morning as well. Love you guys. Appreciate y'all. All right, let's get to it today. Let's get ready to get our communion, and then we're going to get our announcements.
Yes. Well, good morning, everyone. Again, this is our communion service on today.
Yes.
If you have not already went to your refrigerator, please get your grape juice and your crackers. We're going to go ahead and do communion this morning. Communion is a holy ordinance that is to be observed regularly by the church throughout our lives as believers. Mm-hmm. It is a holy time of worship as we come together to celebrate and to remember what our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has done for us. In 1 Corinthians 11 through 17 through 34, we see that the New Testament believers was instructed to observe the communion. So we observe the communion today because the Lord has instructed us to do so.
Yes.
We observe the communion today because of what he has done for us. We observe the communion today because it shows our participation in the body of Christ. And we observe the communion today because in doing so, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes back again. Amen?
Amen.
The bread symbolizes his body that was given to us as a living sacrifice. He was beaten. He was battered. He was broken. And he was bruised for our sakes. The bread also symbolizes the stripes there whereby he bore on his back, whereby we are healed this morning. Amen. The cup symbolizes his blood that was shed for you and I. The Bible says without the shedding of blood, there would be no remission of sins. It is through his blood this morning that we have been pardoned. It is through his blood this morning that we have protection. And it's through his blood this morning that we have purification. So at this time, let's remove let's get our bread, and we're going to go ahead and lift our breads or crackers. Jesus said, this is my body, which is broken for you. Let's do this in remembrance of me. Let's all eat together. Okay, let's get our juice this morning. Lift it up and said, Jesus said, this blood represents the New Testament, and the blood is all as you drink it. Let's do this in remembrance of me. Let's all drink together. Amen. This concludes our communion.
All right. We're going to get ready to get our announcements. So, hey, y'all join in with us on the announcements, and after that, we're going to get the word of God today, all right?
That's right. All right. Of course, everyone know that last week was our Impact Giving Sunday. So I would like to thank you, and Overseer would like to thank everyone who participated and who sowed their seed, their Impact Giving seed. And if you have not already done that, you also have an opportunity to do that in this service on this morning. Yeah. So we'll get more into that at the end of the service, but you definitely have an opportunity to participate if you did not have a chance to participate in our Impact Giving service, amen? And we did have a goal of $10,000. We have not met that goal yet, but we are believing that we'll be meeting that goal in the next few weeks to come. And then also, keep in mind, our Bible study is every Tuesday night with Overseer Perriman and myself. And I'm telling you, the Bible study have absolutely been mind-blowing. It's on Facebook and on Instagram at 7:30 p.m.
Yeah.
So keep in mind to join us. And then also, we have In the Backyard Monday through Friday at 8:15 a.m. with Overseer Perriman. I'm telling you, he has been giving us an encouraging word that will build up our faith and starve our doubts every morning. So make sure you join us on In the Backyard Monday through Friday at 8:15 a.m. Keep in mind, we are definitely still praying for all those who are essential workers, who are on the front line, who are in the hospitals. We're praying for our teachers, our doctors, our nurses, just everyone who is serving in our community. We want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. And we are definitely praying for you. We are definitely praying for those who need prayer immediately after our service on today. So if you would like prayer after our service, that number is 323-238-9915. Again, that number is 323-238-9915. And that is pretty much it for our announcements. Also, we do have our prayer conference call number. If you would like to be a part of our prayer conference call Monday through Friday, you can definitely join us. That number is area code 302-202-1117. And our access code is 534-238. And I want, 283. So again, that's 534-283. And I want to say thank you to those who have been on our prayer conference call. We also have a few new people that have joined us on our prayer conference call. So I want to say thank you to you guys as well. So that's it for our announcements.
All right. Listen, before we get into the word, let's, I know many people have been happy and rejoicing.
Yes.
Because
we're rejoicing.
Because of the new president elect,
yes, we are.
Who's in office? Who will be elected to office fully in January?
That's right.
And I know that for some, that was jubilation for you.
Oh,
for others,
yes.
Others who are watching me today, were not happy about it.
Oh well.
but here's the thing: whether you voted for President Trump or not, whether you voted for President elect Joe Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris, whether you voted for either one of them or not, the one thing that you have to understand is that the Bible gives us a command, and that command is to pray for all of those who are in authority.
That's right.
That's the word of God.
Yes.
Whether you like President Trump's policies or you didn't like his policies, whether you like President-elect Biden or whether you didn't like him, the Bible gives us clear thing, and that is to pray for those who are in authority.
That's
our assignment, to pray for those who are in authority.
Yes.
The other part of this is that we have to look at our nation and see where our nation is, and see that our nation is in crisis.
Yes.
And that the nation needs to be unified. What you're going to see in this season is that we've told you before that the church is in transition.
Oh yeah.
Church is in transition because God is supernaturally transforming the church and taking the church from one place to the next.
Yes.
But the church has to really be the salt of the earth, the light of the world, for real. It has to be that.
Right.
We look at society today and you see that the world is divided. It is so divided.
It's so divided.
There's so much divisiveness in the world today that we have to get back to our country being unified.
Yes.
And our country being healed. We have to get to that place. And it starts with people. A Christian folk.
That's right.
I've watched, I'm being transparent, I've had to control my tongue.
Oh yeah.
Because I've watched Christian people write things and support things of a president that I deem to be chaotic and confusing.
Right. It doesn't stand for righteousness.
Yeah. And I've watched even some from my own church post stuff like that.
Oh, yes.
And I had to realize that I'm a pastor first. People have opinions.
That's right.
They can have whatever opinion they want. They're free to have opinions.
Yes.
It's not up to me to judge their opinion regardless of whether I have an opinion or not. My job is to pastor people and to be able to point people in the direction of God.
Right.
So I'm communicating with you this morning to pray this season. This is a season of prayer. This is a season of warfare.
Yes, it is.
This is a season where we have to bring this nation back to healing. You're going to see more and more prophets get exposed.
Oh, yes.
You're going to start to see more and more prophets get exposed for the lies that they have told and said.
That's
God
right.
has said. You're going to see a lot more of them get exposed. It is not our job to criticize them, to belittle them, or to put them down. It is our job to stand in the gap and make up the hedge. Things are not going to change overnight.
Not at all.
Because we have the new president in office that's going to come in office doesn't mean that things are going to shift and change overnight.
It's going to take some work.
That things are going to be worse than what you have seen. They're not going to change overnight. The COVID is not leaving because we enter into 2021. But for us, we have declared for us that 2021 will be the year of the turnaround.
That's right.
It'll be the year of the turnaround. Things are going to turn around for us.
Turn
it's going
around.
To shift. It's going to turn around. Matter of fact, I need y'all to start typing that right
it's
now.
It's the year of the turnaround.
2021 is the year of the turnaround.
That's right.
That God is going to turn everything around for us. He's going to turn it around.
Oh, yes.
He's going to turn it around. He's going to turn everything around
That's
for
right.
us. Matter of fact, let
That's
me just
right.
stand up right
Woo!
Now. And
stand
let me
up,
just
turn around.
Turn around right now.
Turn around.
Let me just turn around
turn
right
around.
Now.
That's
right. It's going to be a real turnaround for us
yes.
as a church. It's going to be a real turnaround.
Oh, yes.
So what I need for us to do is to not point fingers at people,
Woo.
But come back to prayer. Come back to prayer. Just because they didn't vote for your candidate or you got a thought process about this individual,
right.
that individual,
right.
let's come together in kingdom unity so
Thank
that
you,
our lives can be transformed and changed. This is what this is about. So I need our people to understand this. That this ain't about why I like President Trump, or I like President Joe Biden, I like this, I like that. Listen, God is calling us to prayer. And here's this, I gotta end with this thing right here. Here's the thing that God has allowed many of you to live to see. You live to see the first black elected president serve two terms. You gotta try, you live to see that. The other thing that you live to see was you live to see the first black female vice president to
First.
Be elected. You got
That's
a chance
right.
to live to see that.
Yes.
These are things that people in past generations never thought they would see.
Yeah.
But what you're going to see also in the next 4 years,
mm-hmm.
that if things should hold steady the way they are, and President-elect Biden is president, you will see President Kamala Harris running for president. You'll see Vice
Woo!
President Kamala Harris running for president 4 years from now because he'd be too old to run. And
That's
not
right.
I'm telling you, you're going
Glory
to see
to God.
It. So God is allowing you to live long enough to see certain things take place.
Yes.
And for people who are of Caucasian descent, who are on here today, this is no sleight of hand or no knock towards you.
Not at all.
We want our nation unified,
yes, we
not
do.
Divided.
That's right.
We want it unified and not divided.
Yes.
And so I'm asking you guys to come into prayer for a unified nation.
Yes.
The nation needs to be unified. It doesn't need to be
That's
divided
right.
anymore. We need to be unified. So I'm encouraging you to go down in prayer. Do not point fingers at President Trump. Don't point fingers at President-elect Joe Biden. Don't point fingers at them. That's what's got us in this place today, that we've been pointing fingers at people and not going down in sackcloth and ashes and praying. That's what's needed in this season. You're going to see a wealth transfer like never before taking place.
Oh, yes.
It's going to take place, I'm telling you. So let's get ready to get into this word today. Just so many things have been taking place in this world, and a lot of it God has orchestrated.
Yes.
For such a time as this. And remember, we are Christians first.
That's right.
Before we are Democratic or Republican or Independent. Remember, we are Christians first.
Oh, yes.
And being a Christian means that you are Christ-like.
Yes.
That's what we do.
And we stand for righteousness.
Yeah. So, all right. Get your Bibles. Take them. Look them up high before the Lord. That's all I'm going to address on that situation. I ain't going to address it no more. And that's the Bibles, all right? Say it with me. Say, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
It is the Word of God.
It is the Word of God.
Inside of my Bible.
Inside my Bible.
There's 66 books
of Revelation.
Insights.
Concepts.
Ideas.
Blessings.
And instructions
of
my life.
So today,
I'll be taught
the Word.
I'll hear the Word. I'll receive the Word.
And
my life will never be the same.
In Jesus' name.
All right. Get your Bibles. We're going to the book of Habakkuk. Habakkuk chapter number 2. Habakkuk, some of y'all call it Habakkuk.
Right.
However you want to call it, however you want to announce it. Habakkuk chapter number 2. And we'll start looking at verse number 1. Shout out to Thomas, who's on today. Love you, my brother.
Hey, Thomas.
Shout out to Myra, who's on today.
Hello,
hey,
Myra.
Hey, shout out to the Abner family.
Hello, Minister Casey.
Shout out to you guys. Walter. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. All right, Habakkuk chapter number 2, verse number 1 says it like this. I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved. Verse 2, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon table that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come and it will not tarry. We ask the Lord to add a blessing to the readers and to the hearers of his word today. We're starting a new teaching series today. New teaching series is entitled, I See What He Said. I See What He Said. And we're going to talk about seeing beyond impossibilities. Seeing beyond impossibilities. Again, the title is, I See What He Said. Now, when you start looking at Habakkuk chapter number 2, when you start looking at verse number 1, the writer Habakkuk is writing, and he's frustrated and he's upset because he's seeing so much chaos and confusion, and it seems as if God is not doing anything about it.
Right.
The people are in turmoil. They're fighting amongst one another. It's just all hell breaking loose. War is taking place, and Habakkuk is saying, "You promised us, and where are you? Right. You haven't shown up." And so Habakkuk has been complaining to God. And so here's what he says in verse number 1. I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower. And literally, he was literally upon a tower for real.
Mm-hmm.
And he's saying, and I will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved. Remember, we said the subject is, I see what he's saying. So now we look at verse number 2. Verse 2 says, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain. Make it plain upon table that he may run that readeth it, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. But at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. Now, as I start looking at that, I be really kind of confused because I'm looking at this and I can understand Habakkuk being upset.
Right.
That you ain't showed up for us. You let us be in this situation and circumstance. You ain't done nothing about it. Where are you in the midst of this? Mm-hmm. I can understand that because I've been in that situation before.
Oh, yeah.
God, I don't see what you told me. I don't see what you promised me. I don't see the manifestation of it. Where are you? Why haven't you shown up? Don't you see we're going through this? And I start pointing out the things that I've done good for God.
Right.
God, I serve here. I've done this. This person took care of, took, was against me.
Right.
I didn't fight back. I start pointing out everything. Because I'm frustrated because I need you to show up. Why haven't you shown up?
Mm-hmm.
And so when you look at this, I understand this thing. But the thing that gets me is when you look at verse number 3. Verse number 3 says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. God is speaking to Habakkuk. It says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. At the end it shall speak and not lie, though it tarry.
Yes.
Wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Wait a minute. So this is the confusing part. Why would you use the word tarry in this passage of scripture twice? Why would you do that? This doesn't make sense to me. This almost seems, you said, though it's tarrying, it won't tarry.
Right.
Wait a minute. It's delayed, but it won't be delayed. What the heck is going on here?
Mm-hmm.
So now I got to start studying. I got to go into depths and details when he uses the word tarry. The word tarry in this passage of scripture has two different meanings. The first tarry means to call into question. It means to hesitate. It means to be reluctant. So in a sense now, God is speaking to he's speaking Habakkuk, and he's telling Habakkuk that the vision will not be called into question much longer.
Right.
He's saying to him that not only that, but the vision will not hesitate.
Mm-hmm.
And he said it will not be reluctant to show up. But then when you look at the second tarry, the secondary in this passage of scripture means to loiter behind. It means to slack. It means to procrastinate.
That's good.
So in a sense now, God is speaking to him. He's saying to him, you won't have to call this vision into question anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You won't have to worry about the hesitation of the manifestation of this vision.
Mm-hmm.
You won't have to worry about the reluctancy of this vision showing up.
Right.
And then he starts to tell him, this vision will not be loitering around. to loiter around means to sit idly by and do nothing. And when you're loitering around, you literally bring down the value of the establishment that you're loitering in front of. Right. That's why you see signs that said no loitering.
Oh, yeah.
Because you're bringing it, you're just around here. You're idly doing nothing, mm-hmm. and you're bringing our value down. And not only that, we don't know what you're going to do. You could bring our value down. You could be running customers away from us. And right. potentially, you could steal from us.
Right.
So here's what God said. There will be no loitering. There'll be no loitering with this vision. He says, the vision now will have no loitering. There'll be no slackness to it. And he says, and my vision will not procrastinate.
Right.
I need people to get this and understand it. Because many of you think that your dream and your desire has been gone, that it's over with. And it's not over with. Your dream is not over with.
It's not over.
God said it is not going to procrastinate. It is going to show up. It is going to manifest itself.
Oh,
whatever
yes.
he told you is going to show up. For those of you who have been told that God is going to give you a wife, going to give you a husband. Listen to this. God's words don't sit idly by.
That's right.
They are going to manifest themselves.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen. It's going to show up for you. It's when it shows up, it's going to seem like it showed up out of nowhere.
Woo,
but you're going to have to be positioned to be able to hear. You got to be in a position
yes.
to see what it is that he said.
Oh, yes.
I'm looking beyond impossibilities.
Ooh,
this is why the Bible said, eyes have not seen, nor have ear heard, neither have it entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared for them that love it.
Oh,
so
yes.
there's a prepared thing that God has for you. There's a prepared place that God has for you.
Yes.
There's a prepared purpose that God has for you. But here's the thing. You have to see what it is that he said. You got to see what he said. So here he is. He's reassuring Habakkuk. And he's saying to him, write this vision down. Because he understands, even though I can see something,
mm-hmm.
if I begin to write it down,
yes.
eventually I'm going to say something.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking to somebody right there because you need to get this. This is where your vision board comes into play.
Mm-hmm.
God has given me a dream or something. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to write the dream down so
oh,
I can give voice to the dream so that the manifestation of what I just saw will come to pass. Your sight is tied to your speech.
That's right. You said something just now. You said there's a prepared purpose for us.
Yeah.
Vision gives your life meaning. Without it, your life has no purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Your life have no purpose and it will have no vision. When you have no vision, you are accident ready to happen. Proverbs 21:18 says, "Where there is no vision, the people perish, but he that keeps the law, happy is he." Each and every one of us have a vision.
Yeah.
Yeah.
God has deposited vision on the inside
of
every
one
of us.
Yes.
So watch now. There's some things that God has spoken to you.
Yes.
There's some things that God has dropped on the inside
That's
of you.
That's right.
There's
Write it
thoughts
down.
And ideas, business ideas
oh, yes.
that he's dropped on the inside
That's
of you.
That's right.
But what's happening with people today is you cannot see
Woo.
What he said.
My God.
You can't see what he said.
Mm-hmm.
You have to remove. I like how my pastor, Dr. Hodge, says it. You have to remove vision impediments.
Right. That's what he said.
I got to ask him. Where you come up with this word impediment? So watch now. You got to remove vision impediments.
Right.
You got to remove vision blockages. You got to remove all
remove
of this. Because
move
God
out.
Has something greater for you.
Oh,
this
yes.
is why he said, eyes have not seen.
Yes.
Nor ear
yes, heard.
Neither have it entered into the heart of man the things that he has prepared for them that love him.
Oh, yes.
So God has prepared things, prepared places.
Woo.
He has prepared purpose for you.
Oh,
he
yes.
has prepared people for you.
Yes, he has. He said he'll raise up somebody somewhere to use his power, his ability, and his resources and finances to bless you.
Yeah, so he has prepared. But you got to see beyond
yes.
where you are right now.
That's right.
You got to see beyond it. So many people are blocking their own breakthroughs because you can't see yourself with it.
Oh, yeah.
Let me take you this.
Your own
right?
blessing blocker.
Look, if you can't see yourself with it, you ain't gonna never possess it.
That's right.
If you can't see yourself driving it, you'll never have it.
That's right.
If you can't see yourself living in it, you'll never have
never
it.
Have
if
it.
You can't see yourself wearing it, you never will. So what's now? Your vision now is tied. I mean, your speech is tied to your vision.
Yeah.
You must be able to see beyond.
If you can't
impossibilities.
See yourself. Good. If you cannot see yourself being a homeowner, you'll never own a home. Oh my goodness.
Let's continue on. Let's get to it. We got a few minutes left with this thing. Now, it is the will of God that we understand the purpose of our calling. It's the will of God that you understand. You got to know this, that God wants you to have purpose. All right? He wants you to understand the purpose of your shine. That's a Jackie Hankins term that I learned from her. One day I was talking to her about something, and her daughter was there. She told her daughter, get away, you can't steal my shine. That was the first time I ever heard the word shine and understood what the word shine means from the Ebonic perspective. And so watch this now. God wants you to understand the purpose of your shine. Because to understand the purpose of your shine is to watch now, draw the masses to you.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? See, I'm not shining for my sake.
Not at all.
I'm shining for his sake.
Oh, yes.
I'm talking to somebody today because you missed it.
That's right.
I'm not shining for my sake. I'm shining for his sake.
Right.
I'm allowing his glory to be seen through me. I'm allowing his glory to manifest itself through me. I'm allowing that to take place so that lives can be transformed and changed. It's a mechanism. It's a tool that God uses to draw people to himself. You are part of the tool. You are part of it.
Oh,
so
yes.
You must understand your purpose. Now, watch the Bible now. Let's go to Ephesians chapter number 1. Ephesians chapter number 1, and watch what Ephesians chapter number 1 says, and we'll look at verse number 15. Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 15 says this. Wherefore, this is Apostle Paul writing, he says, wherefore I also, after I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus, and love unto all the saints, cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers. Paul said, I talk about you in my prayers, all right?
Mm-hmm.
This is where I get the revelation from to pray for every one of my members. And to call their names out by God in the presence of God because of this right here. Watch now, verse 17. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation and knowledge of him. Verse 18 says, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Now, let's deal with this for a moment. Pastor, this says, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling. This right here is a mistranslation in the King James Version. When you look at it from a different translation, it says, what is the hope of our calling?
Right.
And what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Watch now. This inheritance, or this rich, glorious inheritance he's talking about, is not just shando shata. It's not just a waving of the hands, but it is also material wealth and blessing that he's put in your hands.
Yes.
He's putting it in your hand so that you can shine, so that the world can know that this is what God has done for this, for his people.
Oh,
and
yes.
The world comes to say, how did you get this? Show me what you're doing. And now you can, now you're in a position to testify about what God has done for you. I need you to get this. So watch this now. God increasing you is not about you. It's about him. I never forget one day I was coming out of the courthouse. I was down there to pay a ticket in downtown Long Beach, and I'm coming by, and this guy is sitting there. He's asking me to give him a dollar. Homeless guy. I said, I'm going to give you a dollar, man, but man, if you come to Christ, man, and start working God's principles, he'll make you wealthy. This is what the man told me. I don't want no wealth. I don't want no wealth. I don't want no riches. I just want me a little something. Give me a soda to drink, a little something to eat. I don't want any of that. And I was saying, hey, man, this is what I'm trying to tell you. He wants you to beat this. Yeah, but I don't want that. I don't want that. I know what it'll do to you. I don't want that. And I'm looking at him like, bro, you homeless. You sitting up here on the bricks asking for money. You're not understanding that God is saying that he wants you wealthy. He wants to take you off the bricks. He wants to take you out of homelessness.
Yes.
He wants to make you wealthy. He wants to do that. And the guy said, I don't want this. Listen to this. It is not about you.
Not at all.
Let me say it to you one more time.
It is not about you.
It's about what he wants to do through you. This is why he gives you dreams that are bigger than you can comprehend. They are bigger than what you can understand because they are not about you. They are about what he wants to do through you. I met people who said, I don't want no big house. I just want me a little house. A little house, 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom. That's all I want. If you don't stop, just stop with all of that. You are limiting what God wants to do through you because of your mentality. It is not about you.
It's
about what he wants to do through you. Well, Pastor, as long as I have me a little piece of car to get where I need to go. Stop with all of that. He don't want you to have a piece of car.
Right.
God can only bless you at the level of your comprehension. So if your thought process is limited, he can only do that. But if you expand your capacity to believe, you can expand your capacity to receive. I'm talking to somebody today. You got to take the limits off of God. This is not about you. It's about what he wants to do through you. So dream big. Stop trying to figure out how you're going to pay for it. Stop trying to figure out how this is going to work and how that's going to work. And let God bless you at the unlimited measure. Let him bless you at that level. Don't let God be hindered because of your inability to believe. It's so important. This is the thing that we got to understand. So watch now. Let me go to another translation of the Bible so you get a revelation today. Let's go to Amplified Bible, Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 15 from the Amplified Bible. And we'll read on. Watch what it says. That's why when I heard of the solid trust you have in the Master Jesus and your outpouring of love to all the followers of Jesus, I couldn't stop thanking God for you. Every time I pray, I think of you and give thanks. But I do more than thank. I ask the God of our Master Jesus Christ, the God of glory, to make you intelligent and discerning in knowing him personally, your eyes focused and clear so that you can see exactly what it is he is calling you to do. Grasp the immensity of this glorious way of life he has for his followers. Oh, the utter extravagance of his work in us who trust in him. Endless energy, boundless strength. Look at what he's saying. Mm-hmm. He said he don't want no limitations on you. So today is the day that you have to say, I'm taking the limitations off of God. He wants there to be extravagance coming through you. He wants it to be because you are the light of the world in this earth. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light in this earth. It is your job to shine. It is your job to draw people to him. And he does it by utilizing you. Now, let's look at the Message translation. No, I'm sorry. That was a Message translation that I read. But let's read from the Amplified Bible, Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18. I read the Message earlier, but this is the Amplified. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18 says, by having the eyes of your heart flooded with light, so that you can know and understand the hope to which he has called you, and how rich is his glorious inheritance in the saints, his set apart ones. So watch what he's doing. He's giving you revelation and understanding that there is a hope in you. He wants you to understand your calling and your purpose.
That's right.
This is why when people come to me and tell me, and they say things like, I believe God has called me to preach. I say, well, come back to me when you're sure. Come back to me when you're sure. Well, I think the Lord is calling me to preach. Come back to me when you're sure. Because there is no thinking in this.
Right.
There is no, well, I believe the Lord may be calling
that's
me.
Not
that's none of that. See, the Bible said make your calling and your election sure. Yeah. See, you got to know you called to this.
Right.
You got to know beyond the shadow of doubt that you are called to this.
Yes.
When you know you called
you
to
know.
This,
yes.
Now all of a sudden understanding comes to you. Revelation comes to you. You understand that this thing is not about you.
Right.
It's about what he wants to do through you. You are the vessel by which he flows through. So now, let's continue on now. Now we got to see what he said. Our subtopic is seeing beyond impossibilities. Now, the word impossible means incapable of happening. It means without strength. It means powerless. It means weak. But seeing beyond impossibilities now is different. It means to look beyond your present condition, your limitations and weaknesses by relying and trusting on the word of God. So in a sense, the word of God will help me to see beyond impossibilities. Let me say it again. It's the word of God that will help you see beyond impossibilities. See, this is why you got to get in this word. When you get in this word, you'll understand that the word of God supersedes anything in the earth.
Oh, yeah.
If he says he gives you houses that you didn't build and vineyards that you didn't plant, if you start believing that and start giving voice to that, then the manifestation of that has got to take place.
It's going to come to pass.
But see, when you don't get into this word, now you are taught and trained by the world system.
Mm-hmm.
So the world tells you that the only way you can get a house, you have to make X amount of dollars.
And you got
to
have a good credit score.
You
got
to have a good credit score. You got to have this, you got to have that.
Uh-huh.
The world puts a criteria on it. And so watch now, because you're not in this word, you follow the criteria.
Mm-hmm.
So in a sense, you're telling God, you can't bless me beyond this.
Woo.
Because this is what the world says. But you've forgotten that God is bigger than the world.
Oh, yes.
He's bigger than the world. He's not limited to the way the world thinks.
That's
he's
right.
not limited to that. So if he told you this, he can do this
he
for you.
Do it.
See, listen to this. God can cause a Saudi Arabian prince
That's
to
right.
build an immaculate house in Los Angeles, California.
Oh, yes.
Build an immaculate house in Brandon,
oh,
Mississippi.
Yes.
And say, you know what? I don't even want this house anymore. Go ahead and take this house, Kim. Go ahead and take this house, Sheila. This
right.
house belongs to y'all. Go
right.
ahead and take it. You ain't got to pay nothing. Matter of fact, I know it's going to cost you about $10,000 or $12,000 a month to maintain it.
Uh-huh.
Don't worry about it. I'm going to handle
you.
It. I'm going to take care of it. I got it. Oh, you'll be like, what?
Mm-hmm.
I got see when you take the limitations off of God, you open yourself up to impossibilities becoming possible.
Oh yes.
Look, I'm talking to people today. You don't know who God will touch to help you. You don't know what God will do to turn things around for you. You don't know. Right. But because I'm trying to fit within the world's criteria, I miss what God has for me.
Ooh.
And there are people today who are watching me. You have missed what God has for you. Some of you work yourself to the bone, to the point you don't really do church. When you do show up for church, you ain't really into it because you're tired, you're frustrated, you can't do this, you can't do that, because you're spending all these hours trying to make ends meet. And you're not realizing you're missing out on a relationship with God because you have not trusted in him.
Right, and you have not put him first.
You haven't put him first.
You have not put him first. You put him on the back burner, and you're doing everything else that you want to do.
Yeah, so our mentality can't be that.
Can't be that.
Now, let's go to Romans chapter number 4, verse 16. Romans chapter 4, verse number 16. We got to see beyond impossibilities. Romans chapter 4, and we'll look at verse number 16. If you're learning anything, somebody shout, "I'm learning something." Well, write it, not shout it. Write, "I'm learning something." Verse 16 says it like this. "Therefore it is of faith that it might be by grace, to the end the promise might be sure to all the seed. Not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. Verse 17, as it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations, before him whom he believed, even God, who quickeneth the dead, and calleth those things which be not as though they were. Who against hope believed in hope that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. Being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body now dead, when he was about 100 years old, and neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God. Verse 21, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. And therefore it was imputed to him for righteousness. Now it was not written for his sake alone that it was imputed to him, but for us also to whom it shall be imputed, if we believe on him that raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead." And verse 25 and final says, "Who was delivered for our offenses and was raised again for our justification." Now watch now. He's given a promise to Abram. In the beginning now, Abram now was not on point like he was supposed to.
Right.
He wasn't believing God like he's supposed to. Now, Romans chapter 4 gives you the finished product of Abraham. It tells you that Abraham was full of faith. Well, in the beginning, Abraham wasn't full of faith because Abraham had a criteria.
Right.
God, if you show me this, you meet this criteria. I believe this, I believe that'll take place.
Yeah.
But now, all of a sudden, now, because of something that God showed him in the Old Testament in the book of Genesis, now the Bible says he's strong in faith. He staggers not at the promise of God through unbelief. The Bible makes a point to tell us that he's 100 years old. His wife is 90 years old.
Yes.
There's deadness in his wife's womb. There's weakness within his body. They're past the age of childbearing. They're past the age of conception. But because he believes God, because he believes God and trusts God, the impossible now becomes possible. I'm talking to somebody today. See, it doesn't matter your age. It doesn't matter your race. It doesn't matter what neighborhood you come from. It doesn't matter any of that. If you hold fast to what God has said, the impossible becomes possible. And let me say it to you one more time. The impossible becomes possible now because you believe God.
Oh, yes.
The word, the Bible asks the question, whose report will you believe? I have made a decision that I'm going to believe the word of the Lord. Yes. I have made that decision.
Woo.
I believe that we will have a house built from the ground up next year. We believe that. We believe that. We believe that. We got seed in the ground for it. Our faith is in the word. Faith is released. My words are being spoken every single day about it.
Yes.
I'm praying about it every day. I'm giving God glory for it every day.
That's right, every
day. The impossible must become possible when you believe. I'm talking to somebody today. You got to step out of your comfort zone and believe.
I believe it.
You got to believe. So the impossible becomes possible when you believe.
Oh, yes. Mm. Oh, yes.
Let's continue on now. Watch now. Receiving from God has a lot to do with my imagination.
Yeah.
Has a lot to do with my imagination. Watch this now. Albert Einstein says, your imagination is your preview of life's coming attraction. Mm. Let's deal with that for a moment. So my imagination is the preview of coming attractions in my life.
Yeah.
So here's why God wants you to dream. Here's why God wants you to think. Here's why God wants you to have an imagination.
Yes.
Because your imagination becomes a preview of your coming attraction.
Right.
I like how Apostle Ivy Hughes says it. He says, imagination really gives you meditation really, it gives you the opportunity to live out your dreams on the canvas of your imagination.
Oh, yeah.
In a sense, you get a chance to visit your future on the canvas of your imagination.
Oh, yes.
So watch this now. With my imagination, I can believe.
Oh, yeah.
I can see myself living in a 10-bedroom home.
That's right. That's right.
Because see, this is our dream right here.
We're talking about our dream.
This is our dream right now. Right. See, our dream is to have a 10-bedroom home. Right. Every bedroom, 9 bedrooms, master bedrooms. You right. understand? They got their own walk-in closet in every bedroom.
Own
you understand?
Bathroom.
Their own bathroom in yes. every bedroom.
Yes.
But the 10th bedroom is to be a master. I don't know if you were
oh,
saying
yeah.
that
that's
was
done
a master.
That's what
you understand? But when we got on a living room like an apartment and
right.
up in our section
right.
like that, you understand what I'm
away
saying?
From the kids.
See, that's our dream.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody might be saying, well, Pastor, Dad, why are you dreaming that big? Because we got a lot of kids, a lot
we
of
grandkids.
We got a lot
of kids.
You understand? We think about when they come home for Christmas.
Oh, yes.
Come home
when they come visit.
For Thanksgiving visit. Everybody got a room. Go
yes.
there. Our dream is to let every one of our children decorate their own room.
That's
even
right.
though they're grown.
That's,
on
right.
the
that's our dream.
That's our dream.
That's
now.
Our
you
dream.
Understand?
I'm
that's our
yours.
Dream. We third floor.
Right.
Belong to us.
Oh,
rest
yes.
of your mother room.
Oh,
you understand?
Yes.
Belongs to everybody else.
Right.
We talk about anywhere from 25,000 to 35,000 square foot.
Oh, yes.
That's our dream.
That's our dream.
You understand?
Right.
That's our dream. Half moon driveway.
Oh,
you understand?
Yes.
With like an 8-car garage. That's our dream.
Right.
Now, whatever you
want
to dream,
whatever you want,
that's on you.
Okay.
But we imagine this thing.
Oh, yes.
That's
yes.
our imagination.
That's ours.
So watch now. With my imagination, I can visit my future.
Oh, yes.
I can see the previews of the coming attraction.
Oh, yes.
I don't know about you,
oh,
but
yes.
I ain't been to the movies in a minute.
Ooh, a minute, huh? Ooh, it's
and
been a minute.
Now we got Netflix and Hulu out. I don't know if I'm going to as long as I got the
moving
fire
right
stick.
Home now.
Well, I got the fire stick, I don't know if I'm going. But watch now. When you go to the movies, and let's say you went there to see Wakanda like Minister Kim 29 times.
Right.
Wakanda forever. And you go to Wakanda, you go sitting in there to
yes.
see the movie. What they end up doing is, after they ask you to be quiet and
mm-hmm.
not make a lot of noise
Can't
and all
laugh.
This type of stuff, they start showing you the previews
right.
of the coming movies for the next year.
For the next year,
they
yeah.
start showing you the previews.
Right.
So watch this now. With your imagination, you can visit your future. You can see the
Ooh,
previews
yes.
of the coming attractions
I
in your life.
It.
You can see this because watch now. It's a movie that you are making.
Oh, yes, yes,
I'm talking
yes.
to somebody
That's
today.
Good.
It's a movie that
it's
you're making.
Yes.
So you got to look at this thing from a different perspective.
Uh-huh.
That I'm going to imagine.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to look at this thing from a different perspective. I'm not going to just sit here and just take it day by day. Whatever's going to be, going to be. That's not what God said about you.
That's not what God said.
That's not what he said about
That's
you.
Not what he said.
So watch this now. We said receiving from God has a lot to do with my imagination.
Oh, yes.
Let's go quickly to Genesis chapter 15. Genesis chapter 15. And we're going to look at verse number 1. Genesis chapter 15, verse number 1. Watch verse number 1. Verse number 1 says, after these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eleazar of Damascus? And Abram said, behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in my house is mine heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, this shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thine own bowels shall be thine heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, look now toward heaven, and tell the stars, or count the stars, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. And then verse number 6 says, and he believed in the Lord, and it was counted to him for righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
So now, let's deal with this for a moment. He deals with his imagination.
Yes.
He's given him a word.
Uh-huh.
Abram can't figure out how the word is going to work. How is this going to work? My wife and I, we old. We tried. We've been trying. We done did in vitro insemination. That didn't work. We done prayed. We done put oil on it. We done sowed seed for it.
Right,
you understand?
Right.
We know the days of ovulation. We've been like rabbits all over the place and just nothing ever. I done been to the doctor. The doctor checked me out saying nothing wrong with my count.
Right.
My wife went to the doctor. There ain't nothing wrong with her.
Right.
So something is wrong here.
Right.
We've been trying to figure it out.
Trying to figure it
and
out.
God is saying, no, that ain't your heir right there.
Mm-hmm.
That's not your heir. The heir is coming from the two of you.
Yes.
And he says, look, come out here. Put a face on every star. Count every star. Tell
yes.
every star. That's how many children you're going to have.
Yeah.
So watch God now. He's allowing him to understand what he wants to do for him through his imagination.
Oh, yes.
This is why you have to imagine yourself owning a home.
Oh, yes.
You have to imagine yourself being married.
That's right.
You just can't imagine yourself having a husband, having a wife. You have to imagine yourself being married. Yes. That is different. Having a husband and having a wife is not the same as being married. You have to imagine yourself being married. Right. You have to imagine yourself. You got to imagine yourself owning the company. You got to visualize. Yes. You got to take the opportunity to meditate. Just sit back and visualize yourself.
Start
writing down what you're visualizing. You're going to see the manifestation of it. It is going to come past because you put pen to pad. It's going to show up. One of my members sent me a note. I'm not going to call their name. Yeah. They didn't give me permission to do that.
Right.
But they sent me a note. Mm-hmm. It was a copy. It sent through text message of the note or something they wrote down in our service.
Oh, wow.
We was having everybody write down on their paper or what they believe, you know, what they're going to see the manifestation of. And the person said, this really worked. Everything was on their list was manifest.
Woo!
Everything on their list was manifest.
My God.
Because watch this now.
Woo!
They took this thing to heart.
They took it serious.
You can't hear a word like this and don't take this thing
serious. Okay, they took it serious.
So they wrote it down, and everything they wrote down on their list has come to pass for them. They named out what they wanted, and the manifestation of it has come to pass.
Yes.
This is the crucial part. Got to understand, receiving from God has a lot to do with my imagination.
Oh, yes, it does.
Listen, I'll never forget, we wanted a Cadillac Escalade. Mm-hmm. And what we were doing was, we didn't have no picture of the Cadillac Escalade. But what we did was, we said, okay, every time we see a Cadillac Escalade, we're going to say, thank you, Lord, for our new Cadillac Escalade.
That's right. We used to see a lot of them, too.
And so we just make it matter. We just talking about it. And then one day we drive down the street, and I just start saying, Lord, I thank you for our new Cadillac Escalade.
Right.
And I'm saying so much, then everybody in the car start catching on to it. And so they start saying, every time they see a Cadillac Escalade, Lord, I thank you for our new Cadillac Escalade.
Yes.
And Trisha would be like, Dad, that's our new Cadillac Escalade. We thank God for it.
Oh, yes.
And one day I got bold enough, I said, when we see one 10 times in a day, that's God letting us know that we're getting close to getting one.
Oh, yeah.
One day I'm counting and I'm thanking God for the new Cadillac Escalade, and one of my members called me on the phone. She goes home to be with the Lord now. Miss Joanne calls me on the phone.
Yes,
I remember
that.
She says, Pastor, how you doing? I said, I'm doing good. She says to me, she wanted me to pray for her about something.
Right.
And she heard me say, Lord, I thank you for the new Cadillac Escalade. She said, what are you doing, Pastor? I said, well, I'm thanking God for the new Cadillac Escalade. That's what I believe. I said, every time I see more than 10 of them in a day, I believe God is going to give it to us.
Oh,
and so she says to me, well, how many have you seen now? I said, 11.
Right.
So she said to me, well, don't you think you ought to go get it now?
Right, that's what she said.
Don't you think you ought to go get it now?
Go get it now.
Huh. I ain't tying the two together.
Right.
You understand? I said, if I see 10 of them in a day, that means we're close to get, God is ready to give it to us.
Yes.
But it didn't dawn on me that I haven't seen more than 10. So we next day we go take my wife to work. I was driving down the street to take her to work over there. My daughter says, Dad, they're going to Cadillac Escalade. I'm thinking that everybody, she's saying, thank you for the Cadillac Escalade. I look to the side. It's pulled up on the
sitting up high on the platform.
It's sitting up on the platform.
Yes, high on the platform.
And so I was like, I don't know. That one's out. I don't know. We'll see. It still don't register to me what Joanne said.
Right.
Go and drop my wife off. Go back. We got to drive right past the Escalade. It's up on the ramp.
Yes,
right there,
it
so
is.
We can see
it.
Got the balloons hanging on everything.
Yes.
We're going back. Now I got to come back and get her. Come back to get her. Still sitting up there. And Trish is like, Dad, I catch her like Escalade. Gonna pick up while we come back by. Mm-hmm. Looking at that Escalade, I said, "Well, we'll see." We come back the next day.
It's still there.
Drive by, sitting up there, and I'm still thanking God for the Escalade. Now, when we come back and get my wife the last time for work, I said, "Joanne said, don't you think you ought to go get it?"
That's right.
Pull right on up in there. Get out the car and go in there and start talking. This lady meets us.
Yeah.
And we start talking to the lady like, "I want that right there." She told me how much it was. Told me how much money I needed down. She said, how much money do you have now? I said, none. I said, none. And so she said to me, well, this is what it's going to take for the car. She said, if it's yours, it'll be here.
Yeah.
I said, all right.
Saying.
So we come back in like 3 days.
3 days.
I got all the $4,000
sure
down payment for the vehicle in 3 days.
Yes.
I got the $4,000.
Oh, yes.
God miraculously worked this thing out.
And
I got the
$4,000
down payment for this thing. And guess what? I'm watching them back it off the
ramp.
Off the ramp.
Off the ramp.
Watch it back it off the ramp and the car looking in
the
truck.
Looking good.
And here we are. Dream manifesting.
Oh, yes. I'm about
to miss the breakthrough because I couldn't connect the dots. That God has already manifested what it is I was believing him for.
Yes.
Put it on display for me to see.
Oh, yeah, up high. It's up high.
And I'm about to miss it. But thank God for somebody being in the car constantly saying, that's a Cadillac Escalade. That's our Cadillac Escalade.
That's treasure.
That's it. That's
treasure.
Our Cadillac Escalade. And so I'm about to miss it.
Uh-huh.
Not realizing that the words that came out of my mouth, that when we see 10 in a day, that's a sign we're getting close to it.
Right.
And I'm about to miss it.
About to miss it.
Get that car, and that car served us well. We put hundreds of thousands,
oh,
hundreds,
yes,
over hundreds of thousands,
we put hundreds of miles on that vehicle. Thousands.
And then towed a doggone car, the truck up.
Oh my God, a bus hit it up.
And
a metro bus hit
right
our car.
Right in front of Minister Casey's house. Opened up the door, and
the bus tore that door off.
Boom! So now I'm jacked up. I got to tie stuff around to keep the
door. Yes! Oh my God. Oh my God, right in front of Minister Casey's house.
Listen, I'm trying to tell you that God can manifest it.
Oh, yes.
He can manifest it. That's really our time for right there. Honey, you got anything you want to add?
Oh, that was so good. That was so good. Oh my goodness. I'm telling you, whatever you're believing today, you can have it.
Yeah.
But you got to believe it. To manifest, to let it come to pass, you have to believe it.
You got
to
believe
it. You got to believe it.
Receiving from God has a lot to do with my imagination.
Oh, yes. You got to see it.
Listen, I must see what he said.
Oh, yes.
If I can see what he said, I will see beyond the impossibilities.
That's
and
right.
I'll have what he said.
You'll have what he said. Yeah.
Listen, get ready to get your seed in the ground today. Listen, we are prepared to do some great things. I need y'all to get your seed in the ground today.
Yes.
Let me let y'all in on some things right now.
We
already paid the money for our website.
The website
is going to be redone and everything. And man, all of our broadcasts are going to stream live from our website.
Eventually, going
to stream live from our website.
Yes.
Go straight to Facebook and YouTube and not Instagram, but YouTube. Periscope TV, all those places at one time. So we're getting prepared
for this.
I'm telling you, it's going to be amazing.
We're going
to be tapping Josh pretty soon.
We're
going to
have that worship
pre-record the worship.
We've
already been in communication with some live streaming companies
as to how we can do this properly.
We got to buy one of those Mevo cameras or whatever.
Yes.
But hey, we're on the verge of doing something great. Been in communication with somebody about doing a new church app. We are ready to go. I'm telling you,
by the beginning of the new year,
it's going to be a whole new thing you're looking at. That's why we need your partnership. That's why we need your connection to come on partner with us. I want to say thank you to everybody who's been partnering with us and everything. It's going to be fantastic. It's going to be phenomenal
the things
that we're going to do. All right. So we've been, things are going to be different. I'm telling you. So y'all come on. Be a part. Get your seed in the ground. This is not a ministry who's withholding things and just doing frivolous things with it.
Not at all.
This is not what we do. We are doing everything we said we are going to
That's
do.
That's right.
So
everything.
We need y'all to come on, be a part. We had to buy a laptop and everything. So it had to buy not just a laptop, but the right laptop.
Yes.
In order to be able to push what we needed to push.
There's new technology.
Woo, as you can see, technology is increasing right before our eyes. This is divine.
Yes.
And so in order for us to reach people, this is what we have to do.
Right.
All right? So listen, we're getting ready to do this. We've been playing around with some of the technology and things like that. But we're going to have a full-on worship service with the announcements coming through the screens and everything.
Yes. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be amazing. So
yeah.
I need y'all to come on partner with us. And man, we're looking to have our new building and everything.
Once
we move into our new building.
Yes.
We're not going to leave the people behind who live in other states.
Not at all. You're
going to be a part of a full service.
Yes, that's
going to be transformational. So I need y'all to come on, get your seat in the ground. Don't let the devil stop you from giving. Don't let the devil drop in your head that all the preachers want is your money. That's not what we're about.
Not at all.
We are pushing next level things.
Oh, yes.
That's what we're endeavoring to do. Hey, our new talk show is going to be coming pretty
soon.
Oh,
yes, it is.
So listen, man, we've been working on some stuff.
I'm so proud of you.
We've been working on some stuff. I'm telling you.
At one point,
I had a broadcast a while back called Next Level Living Today.
Yes.
But I think I'm going to come up with a different name.
All
right. It needs to be something quick and catchy.
Yes.
And so we're going to be, it's not going to be just a Christian broadcast.
Right.
But we're going to be interviewing all types of people from all walks of life. Definitely going to interview people from our church. You know, we're going to be talking to people about partnership. We're going to talk about people about their personal life, how
yes.
God has delivered them
oh,
and
yes.
things of that nature.
Marriages.
We're going to talk to people about starting their business. How did
yes.
you start your business? Why did you start it?
Right.
You know, where did you come from? All of this thing. We're
yes.
going to do it. Going to be done live through Zoom.
That's right.
So that it can go through Facebook and everything. So I'm telling y'all, you got to connect. So we can have multiple people on at one time. That's why we're going to do it through Zoom.
Yeah.
So we can have multiple people on at one time. And so, man, we're going to talk to people about, you know, how do they get through forgiveness? All of this thing.
Right.
So y'all got to come on, pray with us. We're going to touch the hearts and minds of people.
Oh, yes,
I got
we
a thought
are.
Process. One of the first person I'm going to interview, the first one is going to be my pastor.
That's right.
Because I need my broadcast
oh,
blessed.
Yes.
So
oh,
I'm going to interview
yes.
my man of God
yes.
and talk to him
oh,
about
yeah.
certain things, man. So we're going to have people on here. It's going to be phenomenal. We're going to talk to Miss, I said Minister Karen Yates. We're going to talk to Miss Karen Yates.
That's right.
About the power of intercessory prayer.
Oh, yes.
What it really means. You understand all of that. So you got to come on. We're going to talk to people about going through issues, how they came out of it.
Yes.
You understand? We want to bring hope to a hopeless world.
That's
we want
right.
to bring unity to a world that is not unified. So y'all got to come on and partner with us. Man, we got to take more pictures and everything. So we got pictures set of when we took it at our churches
yes,
with
did.
Our members. So some of them are going to appear
on the screen.
On the screen. Not on the screen, but they're going to appear on our website.
On our website, yeah.
So y'all got to get ready. We're going to have an e-book coming out pretty
Woo!
Soon. An e-book, e-booklet, not a book. E-booklet.
E-booklet.
Coming out about 2021.
Yes.
And what was, because man, you know, I want our people to understand. We own this thing
oh,
for real.
Oh, yes.
Because this is no joke. We want this thing for real. That's why we need your seed sowing.
That's right.
So that we can be able to email this thing out to you.
Oh, yes.
If you got friends who want to know about our church, you can just, boom, email that the email booklet to them.
Right.
Man, and be a part. I think we had one other person who said they wanted to be a member of Kingdom Life Faith Center.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is no joke. We are moving.
We have another member.
So y'all gotta come on and get with us, pray with us
That's
daily.
Right.
Let God bless. I'm telling you, we are about to go to the next level for real, for real.
Oh yeah.
So
oh,
y'all
yes.
come on and partner with us. So listen, I need to see y'all more in attendance on Bible study nights. I need
That's
to
right.
see y'all in attendance on our upcoming leadership meetings and things like that. Your church is not just sitting around. We're moving.
We're moving.
So, you know, so some things we got to get. Some of these equipment is not cheap. These Mevo cameras are not cheap. You understand? But they'll do everything we need them to do.
Oh, yes.
So I need y'all to come on, be a part, and pray with us. It's going to be amazing. So listen, y'all share, like, tag, invite, get your seed in the ground. Go to our website, kingdomlifefaithcenter.org. Click on the online giving button there and get your seed in the ground today, all right? Hey, if you want to sow through the cash out to the church, just do the $KLFC
right.
church. Again, the $KLFC church. Get your seed in the ground today. If you want to sow toward the Vision Impact Giving seed, if you're doing it through the Cash App, all you got to do is just say on your four line or your memo line that it's your Vision Giving Impact seed. We know how to, the accounting team knows how to put it into proper place and everything, so you can get your credit for it.
Right.
And not only that, but hey, you can also sow your Vision Giving Impact seed on our website as well, all right? Now, hey, don't forget your pastors in your giving. This is how we live, through the free will offerings of our members, so don't forget us in your giving. The way you can do that is you can sow directly to me through the Cash App. It's the $ Pastor C. Perryman. Again, the $ Pastor C. Perryman. And for my wife, it's the $ Pastor Sophia, all right? So get it in the ground today. We love y'all. We appreciate
yes,
y'all.
We do.
Our website is going to be up-to-date with a lot more beautiful things
oh,
on it.
Oh, yes.
It's going to be up-to-date. Right now, we outdated right now, but we're going to be up-to-date in just a moment. And so, man, y'all just wait and see. It's on its way, all right?
Oh, yeah.
So we love y'all. We appreciate y'all.
Yes, we do.
So listen, don't forget the number to call us after the service is over if you need prayers, 323-238-9915. Again, 323-238-9915. So get your seed in the ground today, all right? We love y'all. We appreciate y'all so very much. And we'll see y'all again tomorrow morning at 8:15 a.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Yes.
On In the Backyard with Pastor Perry. All right, love y'all. And
love
I got to go see if the Saints going to get the brakes beat off.
Uh-oh.
See the problem. All right, love y'all. Be blessed.
Love you guys.